which between the tri-state boundaries of Goa, Karnataka and Maharashtra lies an incredibly rich biodiversity hotspot. Home to tigers, leopards and scores of other threatened species, its silence only broken by the constant hum of cicadas. A region not only abundant in a vast diversity of life forms, but one also rich in minerals, a dangerous quality for any forest, and a huge draw for the mining industry.
The Madhai region is an amazing place to begin with. These forests have a large piece of land, in fact a lot of large portions of land which are not secured, which are not with government forests but in private ownership, and there was one section of land which was very crucial because it was the birthplace of almost 6 or 7 waterfalls, and was being slated for mining. Mining in India is open caste. It actually leaves really wide scars on forest ecosystems. Goa as a state has had a history where mining has affected our forest in absolutely irreversible ways.
Only 21 at the time, a young Nirmal decided to start reaching out to people. And his quest led him to Captain Nitin Dhond, a merchant navy captain who believed in the same idea. It was time to save a forest.
I remember the first 30 acres of land that Captain Nitin bought. It came as a lot of joy that we had our own forest and that we could do something about it in terms of conserving it for long term. Then we realized that that forest patch that we had did not have a water body. So we had to take another piece of land which had a water body. And that is how, step by step we started securing land.
But now it was time to earn the trust of the villagers who lived in the forests, the ones who would have benefited the most from the mining industry.
I remember going to meetings in villages with Captain Nitin, being asked questions in temples, because that is supposed to be the sanctified place where you speak the truth. And being asked questions by villagers saying that mines would provide jobs. What is the alternative, or what would you give? And we would keep telling them that, the alternative that we would provide would be sustainable, or can be exhausted.
That is when the idea of ecotourism took seed.
A completely alien word at that time, but there was some talk going on that, it supports forests. We decided that we would do something that will not only be sustainable and will support the local community, but also stand as a model. This was the beginning of the Swapnaganda story.
Today, Swapnaganda Resorts Private Limited operates 2 resorts, Swapnaganda and Wildernest. And the company owns and protects about 700 acres of forest land in the Western Ghats. In keeping with the principle of minimal interference, the resorts itself take up only 3 acres on this sprawling property. Another 15 acres are used for nature trails.
And then there is the remaining, 650 plus acres of land, which is strictly our core zone, where researchers are allowed after screening, and nobody else can go. That we treat as a private sanctuary.
These 700 acres of land also act as a wildlife corridor connecting Bhimgarh Wildlife Sanctuary in Karnataka to Madhe Wildlife Sanctuary in Goa and to reserve forest areas in Maharashtra.
It's a known wildlife corridor because we are doing a constant and regular camera trapping for almost 5-6 years now. We know what is the time where tigers from Bhimgarh and Madhai they go towards Tilari and when is the time when the females from that area come to our areas. Apart from wildlife corridor, we are also a huge catchment which is continuously feeding water to major tributaries of Vadvanti River, which are again a tributaries of Madhai River. And if you look at the whole area and forest that we have, we are now responsible for water supply to more than 25% population in Goa state, the entire North Goa. It gets water from our region.
The resorts only employ local villagers who are then trained in various departments, like Sushma, the operations manager of the Swapnagandha resort, or Vithal, the camera trap expert.
My focus is on camera trapping and birding, which is ornithology. I study it. I have a full direction and camera trapping databases collect from the Kutla Prani, photo capturing and dropping collect. जेव्हा लहान होतो आता म्हणजे 8वी 9वी होतो तेव्हा माझे आजोबा इथे सांस्कृतिक कार्यक्रम घेऊन यायचे म्हणजे तालगडी म्हणतात त्याला माझे सर आहे
ऑर्बिटॉलॉजिस्ट निर्मल
जास्त सोबत त्यांनी फील्ड गाईड स्टडी कसं करणं कुठल्या पक्ष्यांचं ना त्यांचे आवाज हे निरीक्षण करणं शिकवलं स्नेक हँडलिंग याच्यावर स्कोप दिला जास्त.
At last check, the resorts support 120 families directly and about 300 plus families indirectly in this region. Empowering communities has also meant questioning age-old traditions and overthrowing entrenched prejudices.
In our villages, people still follow the caste thing. At the beginning, they started doing don't touch that person, don't take that plate. Then I also spoke to some people. This is not like that. What happened if people are coming here as a guest and they are belong to the same caste and because of they are rich people, they are paying to us, we treat them like our same guest as the same level. And if the people are belong to the poor family and if they are coming here as a worker, why should treat them like that? So slowly people start understanding.
15 years after it started operations, Swapnagandha has not only protected vital forests, but has also curbed poaching, provided livelihoods, and saved the catchment areas of two important tributaries of the Madhe River. But challenges continue to crop up.
The current process of monoculture plantations is at its worst. Forests are completely cut down and rubber is being planted. This not only causes siltation and can cause anything from flash floods to large scale deforestation and water shortage, but we are losing these forests and can never be replaced in its true sense, in its true form. If forests go, one of the most important aspects, which is of a natural resource, which is water, will get impacted. Water does not come from the tap, it comes from the forest. This, as soon as possible, as many people understand, is what would change. I think for us at Wilderness, this is what we need to tell people, and this is what our communities and our teams over here are engaging with people to tell them that.